Welcome to Learn Commerce PU online classes. Don't forget to like our video and subscribe our YouTube channel for all the updates.
Welcome to second PU Computer Science online classes. Today we are in the new chapter, the chapter name Database Concept. Chapter 13, Database Concept. Now, before going to tell the meaning of database, or maybe application of the database, or what is data, what is information, or maybe what is fact here. So each and everything, first of all, let's see, shall we start by using the introduction of the database. So in this unit or in this chapter, we are going to discuss about data. Or we can say as the large data and complex data here, and which are collected or maybe entered, stored, and after entering, storing, we are going to access based on the use of the or needs of the user here, or we can say that based on the needs, based on the used, we are going to access all those data here. But to access all those data, we need to use some of the software. So here, the Unix software are developed and also used in this case here. And whatever the software we are going to use are highly secure. Why? Because we know that here database means here we are going to collect the data, we are going to collect the related data. One example, student information. In student information, we are going to collect the related data, maybe the student name, maybe the student class, or we can say address of the student here. So all those, or the class section, all are called as the related data here. So, Unix software are developed and used and which are highly secured. Why? Because whatever the data, if you are not going to, if you are collecting, if such data is not secure here, that means very difficult to collect the data. Because everyone going to access such data, so we need some secure action in our database. So, whatever the data we collected, which are highly secured in our database and also complex. So let's, in this unit, we are going to discuss about database concept. So first of all, I'm going to start by using the meaning of the database concept here. So in our database concept, we can say that the meaning of the database, a database is a collection of logically related data. Okay, why? Because I already gave one example, student information. In student information, many related data we are going to collect about the student here. So we can say the database is a collection of logically related data organized in a way that the data can be easily accessed, managed, and updated. Clear this point here? That means it is a collection of logically related data. And whatever the data we collected, such data we need to organize in a particular manner, in a correct format here. And after the organization or organized of such data here, such data can be easily, it possible to access whenever you want. You can access the data from the database here, or maybe managed in this case. When you want to make some manageable action, we can make the manageable action also by using the database, and also such a data can be updated. That bit updated means if you want to make some changes in the data of the database. So we can say that the database, meaning here the database is a collection of logically related data here organized in a way that the data can be easily accessed, managed and updated. Correct no kya? So let's, why? Because here I'm going to use some of the example. So first of all, I'm going to start about some more introduction, some more meaning about the database here. We know that today database is used everywhere. Correct no? Maybe you want to collect any information, student information. That means such information we are going to collect call as the database. In case of the banking also, maybe customer information, here also we can so say as the, it is one kind of the database here. Or maybe many kind of, maybe the finance information, or maybe the purchase information, sales information. So whatever the information we are going to collect, such one is called as the database here. So today database is used everywhere, correct no? And all walks of life here. So we can say that the database is becoming the backbone of all the software, correct no? Why? Because by using, with the help of the software, we are going to access the data, we are going to collect the data, we are going to enter the data here, saving of the data, and laterwards we are going to access the data here. So database is becoming the backbone of all the softwares here. That means maybe the client server software, online software here, or maybe the mainframe computer, supercomputer, everything are using to collect all those data of the database here. That means after collecting, we are going to keep all those data, maybe by using online services, or maybe by using client server in this case here, or maybe by using our supercomputer or the mainframe computer. So whatever the data we collected by using all those, so such data is going to use in the business purposes, correct no? Maybe some are going to use in our business purposes. If he is an authorized user here, then only he is going to use in our business purposes. Or maybe service organization going to use such database in this case here. And also we can say that about organization also going to use all those data in this case. So simply we can say that wherever the data and information is required, that the database software is used, correct no? Why be using the database software? Maybe when you are going to collect any information on that tab, we need to use such a database software. So just in simple words I said here, wherever the data and information, whatever the data and any kind of information you want to, or you want, or you required in this case, that we are going to use the database software in this case here, correct no? And after collecting all those information, the results are presented in the form of, maybe in the form of the reports in this case, or we can say as the graphical representation in this case. And after collecting all those data, going to prepare such a database information, going to prepare with the help of the reports in this case here. Why? Because maybe in case you are going to prepare all those information with the help or by using our reports, or in field of the reports in this case here, that means all those report which are very easier for understanding, correct no? So that we can say that all those future activities can be carried out by using these reports. Why? Because first of all, we collected the data and we entered the data here. While going to enter the data in our database, we need to use some of the database software. By using or with the help of the database software here, we enter the data here, and by using the all those information, we prepared some of the reports in this case here, or we can say as the graphical representation. So if in case you are going to prepare in reports, so which are very easier for understanding, so that any kind of activities or maybe in future we can use the such reports here. So we can say as the, so that the future activities can be carried out by using these reports in this case. Now let's, why, because now still here we know the meaning of the database here, and I already said how we are going to collect the information, which type of information, and what about the database concept, each and everything. Let's see such a database concept we are going to discuss by using one example in this case here. So the one of the area where database is used can be the schools in this case here, correct? No, why we using such a such a database is going to use in our schools here? Why? Because one of the area we are going to use can be, we can say as the, in case of the schools here, and in case of the school we are using the database software. Why? Because for the fees payment software, correct? No, here the fees payment software in this case, while going to collect the fees from the student here. So one example just I am giving here for the fees payment software. And maybe if it is new student admission, so the basic requirement for new student admissions are maybe the student name we need to enter, correct? No, by using the software here. And maybe we can say as not only the name of the student, we also going to enter some other informations like admission number, student ID here, or maybe the father name of the student, or maybe the class of the student, section of the student here, and the amount, correct? No, the amount of fees or fees amount in this case, or maybe the date of entry into the school are going to enter and save just with the help of the software. That means such one is called as the database. In database, maybe the new student admission, we are going to select, we are going to collect some related information of the student, the student name, admission number kya, student ID, maybe the amount, date of entry into the school, father name, address of the student. So all those are the related information, correct no kya? And like that only we can perform some other activities by using the software kya. By using the software we can perform some other activities, can be the admission fees, or maybe the annual fees we also going to check in this case here, or maybe the monthly fees information, or finally we can say that the late payment, each and everything are created and respective report are generated with the help of the database software here. So this is about some point in case of the introduction of the database concept. So clear this point here. So just only in our introduction I completed first of all the meaning of the database. Now I think it will be clear to everyone about our database concept. It is a collection of related, logically related data organized in a way that the data can be easily accessed, managed and updated, correct no kya? Updated here, that means we are going to collect the information, such one is called as the database kya. And later words I used some of the example, the one example, the simple example I used for the database, the collection of related data, that is the fees payment software. And while going to get the fees of the student, many information we need to enter kya, correct no kya? So depend on the entering of the information, we are going to enter all those information, such one is called as the database kya. And later words, now let's see the application of the database. Now we know that the application is called as the users of the database. We know why, because the database are widely used in many cases, in many field we are going to use the database. So here some of the representative applications are, the first application is about our banking. So in banking, how we are going to use the database, in which manner we are going to use the database. So the first application is the banking in this case here. So we can say that in our bank, the database, or we can say the uses of the application of the database in our banking as for customer information. Why? Because maybe the name of the customer, the type of account in this case here, the balance amount, each and every information. So for customer information kya, or maybe any loan information, or maybe any account information, or finally we can say as the banking transaction, for the collection, for checking about the banking transaction, that means the amount of funds transferred kya, or maybe the refund, each and everything. So the first one, so everything is called, why? Because we are in the concept of the users of the database. We know that the meaning of the database. Now application, the first application is called as the banking. Yeah, so in our banking, how we are going to use for customer information, maybe to collect the loan information here, or maybe for our account information, and also for our banking transaction, for the fund transfer, each and everything. So all those information is called as the, if you are going to collect kya, such information is called as the database. And the second thing about our water meter billing. So in our water meter billing, we can say that first of all, yeah, the RR number going to use here. Now what about the RR number we are going to use in our water meter billing in this case here? So why? Because such RR number we must need to enter into the water meter bills in this case here. And such number, the RR number, totally it holds 8-digit number. Clear this point here? It is totally, it including the 8-digit number. Maybe the one example we can say as the W minus or 1999, or maybe the 38. Clear? So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So this is one example for the RR number of the water meter billing. So we can say that, why? Because the water meter billing, we must need to enter the 8-digit number to view in this case here, or to know the water meter bills information in this case here. Or simply we can say that the RR number means it is the user ID. Clear this point here? It is the user ID. By using such a user ID, we know each and every information about the water meter bills in this case here, and all store information about our water meter billing we will get. So such one is called as the database, and such information is connected to the server based works. Clear this point here? So the second application we can say as the water meter billing. So in case of the water meter billing, we using the RR number. Why? Because such RR number holds the 8-digit number kya. So here I already written one example for our RR number. So such RR number is also calling as the user ID. And why we using? Why? Because to view or know the water bills in this case. All those information are stored in the water meter bills in this case, and such information is connected to the server based works here. And the third one thing about our rail and railways and the airlines information, it also calling as the, whatever if you are going to collect about the rail information, it also call as the database, or maybe the airlines information is also called as the database. Yeah. So were we using in case of the rail and airlines. So here we can say that for reservation, correct? No, maybe any kind of the reservation, whatever the reserve is there here, each and every information will get. So why? Because here the information going to collect, such one is called as the database. So for reservation and schedule information, maybe the arrival timing, departure timing, for each and every information we are going to collect here. So in case of the rail and airlines, for the reservation and schedule information, it called as the database. So in case of the airlines, where the user use the database in geographically distributed manner, correct? No, whenever they want to get some information, they are just selecting the database in this case here and getting all those information. So here we can say that means whatever is that, first of all we need to collect all those information properly, and laterwards we are going to store in one place, maybe in computer or maybe anywhere in this case here. So we can say that all those terminal situated around the world, anywhere, by setting anywhere we can collect any type of information about the rail and airlines in this case here. So the terminal situated around the world in this case here, and maybe going to access the central database system through the phone lines or maybe call as the other data networks, correct? No, so any information we can collect, whatever the information is there about the rail and airlines, we are going to collect maybe through phone lines or by using the other communication or other data networks. So this is about our rail and airlines. Now let's see in case of the colleges, how we are going to collect the information. So in case of the colleges, the for student information, when you are going to collect any student information, that means such collected information is called as the database. So for student information in this case here, for the registration also calling as the database here, and also maybe the course information, it also called as the database, or any information about the grades of the student. So for that we are going to use all those database. So this is the information about the colleges, correct? No, maybe the college here. And next thing about our credit card transactions, our fifth point is the credit card transactions. So how we are using in our credit card transaction, that means for the purchases of the credit cards, maybe you are going to purchase anything by using the credit card, it also called as the database in this case here. So for the purchase on the credit card here, or maybe the generation of the monthly statement of the credit card, it also called as the database. Clear this point here? So this is about our fifth point, that is the credit card transaction. And let's see in our sixth point. The sixth point is the telecommunication. So how it is called as the database? Why? Because in our telecommunication, we are using for keeping the call of records, mean how many records, how many calls we made to the other members here, maybe to your friend, family. So whatever is called as the collection of information of the calls made here, such one is called as the database. So in our telecommunication, we can say that for keeping the record of the calls made here, or also we can say as the generation of the monthly bills of the telecommunication, and maintaining the balances on the prepaid calling cards here, maybe the prepaid calling card information, it total information, or it is, or whatever the information we are going to collect, it also call as the database in this case here. Or finally, storing all information about our communication network here, so such is called about our database in this case. So this is about our telecommunication. And let's see the next seventh point. The seventh point is called as the finance. So how we are going to use, how we are going to collect, and what about here application, how it related to the application of the database in case of the finance. Why? Because in our finance, we are going to or for storing the information about the holdings, correct? No, maybe any information about the holdings, maybe the information about our sales, purchase of the financial instrument, maybe the stock and bonds. So whatever the information we are going to collect in finance, that one is called as the database here. So clear this point here. In case of the finance, we can say that maybe, that means here we are going to collect the sales information, or maybe any purchase of the financial instrument, maybe when you are going to purchase the stock, when you are going to purchase the bonds in this case here, maybe sale of the bonds or sale of the stock here, each and everything that is comes in case of the application of the finance here. And later the eighth point is called as the sales. So in our sales, why? Because for customer information, correct? No, when you are going to collect the customer information, that is called as the database, the collection of information here. So for customer information, for the product information, for the sale as well as the purchase of the product information here. So this is about our sales in this case. And later next one, the ninth point, we can say as the manufacturing. Clear this point here. And how we are going to, in manufacturing, what we are telling as the, it is called as the database. In case of the manufacturing, we can say that here the production of items, okay, kya? The production of item in the factories here. So the total number of production of item in the factories, that means here we are going to collect the information about the production of item in factories, or maybe any item or item in the warehouses in this case here. Warehouses means the, it is a place where we are going to keep all those production of items. Production of items in this case here. So this one is about our manufacturing and also the order for items. Clear this point. It comes in case of the manufacturing. And finally, we can say about our human resources. Clear this point here. The last 10th point is called as the human resources. So in case of the human resources, how we are going to collect the database, maybe the collection of employees information, maybe the collection of salaries, employees salaries information, maybe the benefit that is provided to the employees here, or maybe the generation of the paychecks that is come. And totally whatever the collection, whatever the information we are going to collect about the employees, about their salaries, about the benefits of the employees, maybe the payroll taxes in this case, or finally the generation of the paychecks, that one is called as the human resources here. So totally we can say that in our application of the database, first one is the banking, second one is the water meter billing, third one rail and airlines, next is the colleges, next credit card transactions, telecommunication, finance, sales, manufacturing, and the last point, that is the human resources. Thank you.